Hey, welcome back to Trending Live, and hi everyone watching at home and on Twitter and YouTube as well, where we are streaming now. Don't worry about it. Now, Rebecca, have you seen in the news recently? There seems to be a whole load of celebrities falling out with each other. We had Cardi B and Nicki Minaj. They actually had a full-on fight, and a shoe ended up being thrown. Wasn't pretty.
Can't we just get along?
Cardi B got a big lump on her head.
It's very tense. That is very, very tense. I remember last week what Zayn said about One Direction. He basically said that none of them, well, he's not friends with any other members from One Direction anymore.
Oh, it made me very sad. Made me very, very sad. Bad news for 1D fans. But is there any way that they could reconcile? Surely there's hope yet. Well, we've got just the person to tell us in this week's What to Do If. What to do if you fall out with your friends.
Woohoo! Now, we are joined by relationship expert Evelyn from Seven Career Coaching. Welcome to the show.
Yes, Evelyn.
Come on. Woo! Yeah, you are. First of all, can you tell us if this is something you've experienced in your own life? Do you feel like most of the stuff you know now is because of past experiences from yourself, if that makes sense?
Yeah, I think it's just so common, especially with groups of girls. And when you're younger, I mean, when I look back now, I just think like so much drama could have been prevented. Half of it was almost about the drama.
Yeah.
And now as as you mature, you think half of that was totally unnecessary and it didn't actually matter.
Yeah.
At all.
Yeah, everyone goes through it. But can it be quite damaging for you mentally if you fall out with somebody and then end up holding a grudge?
I think one of the things that can be most damaging is obviously social networks are really important to our mental health and being connected and feeling like you belong. So that's actually the most damaging thing, is if you all of a sudden kind of like lose your group of friends, which happens to like regularly to like teenagers or people at different stages, that's what's most damaging. Yeah. I think holding a grudge is just negative energy, and it just takes up a lot of energy that you could be putting into positive, constructive things like making new friends.
Aww. Exactly.
I can imagine a lot of people, like your friends and like random people, will come to you for advice. Would you say you're like always the peacemaker? Do you always want people to like... Oh, so you're
the hellraiser.
So you're like, in some situations you'll be like, you know, make up with each other. In other situations you're going to be like, forget, move on, you're never going to be friends again.
I think we're kind of conditioned to be compliant and not rock the boat. And I think sometimes it is about, like in Zayn's case with 1D, it's like there's a lot of bitterness there.
Yeah.
Like, is it worth going back to that? Is it worth maybe just moving forward, clean slate, stop bitching at each other on Twitter?
Yeah.
Just move on.
Yeah.
Get over it.
Yeah.
There's loads of other people out there that you can have great friendships with, and you've all kind of evolved into new people. Move on and get
over
it.
Just gotta move on. But how do you recognize when it's worth moving on and when it's worth sticking and trying to, like, you know, piece it back together?
You know by your heart how you feel. I think if it's like, it depends, it's all about the individual. Like, it's like, you know, how much are you losing? Are you losing out so much emotionally? Are you so upset? Is your life like not really rich because of this situation happening? You're really losing out.
Yeah.
If that's happening, then maybe you need to do something about it. And it's just based on how you feel, like as a person. It doesn't matter about anyone else. Even if you sort of have to lose face and not look cool by going, you know, and saying, look, I just want to kind of create a peaceful situation. Maybe we don't need to be friends, but the energy of the conflict is actually making everyone lose. So let's just like get on over that and then kind of free yourself a bit, I guess.
Just quickly, if anyone was offended by any language just before, I'm not sure what was said, but I've been asked to apologize. So, so there we go. Is there a point where, you know, so say you're trying to make up with a friend if there's been some sort of fallout. What's the best way to kind of approach that situation? How do you piece things back together? What's your end point?
I mean, I think every situation is so different, and I think it's just got to be authentic to you. I mean, if it's a really, really kind of bitter, difficult, toxic situation, I think, you know, be very, very careful about making any moves forward and really kind of consider it first.
Yeah.
I think if you're just doing it purely for you, like, we win when we forgive, we lose when we hold a grudge. That's not about the other person, that's about us.
Yeah.
So if you just want to move on in your own life and just feel better, sometimes, like, you're not forgiving the person really for them, you're forgiving for you, and you end up winning.
For your own closure.
I really like that.
For your own peace of
closure.
Mind.
Closure, exactly, that's the perfect word.
And have you ever had, like, someone, after you've given them advice, they've come back to you and been like, you've just made me, like, make the wrong decision, like, what you told me was wrong, or it's kind of like, you don't hold...
Like as a life coach and as a coach, you don't really give people advice in the way I'm doing it now. Okay. You kind of facilitate, like you help them to get in touch with what they want from a situation and then understand within their, like the, you know, who they are as a person, what's going to be right for them. Yeah. But it comes from them, not from me. Like we facilitate that. We create a framework where they can kind of get in touch with them. And then they'll make, the actions they take will be authentic to them, not necessarily to the coach or to me.
Well, let's talk about Cardi B and Nicki Minaj. Obviously, they've had this massive fallout. A stiletto was thrown, and now they're still kind of, that beef is still rolling on now.
It's a bit frosty, isn't it?
Very frosty, to say the least. Do you think they should try and make up, or do you think they just need to ignore each other and stay out of each other's lives?
I would love to see them making up, because I think they're both like alpha females, they're killing it, they're just totally ripping like off the rule book, and I think they're really strong female role models that I think any woman just thinks go for it. I love that.
Yeah.
So it'd be lovely to see them like work together.
Yeah.
Like in the Me Too movement, it's like, why are you guys like catfighting? It's so like 80s. Come on, get over it.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think we'd all love harmony, but at the same time, I think a feud sells a lot more albums and a lot more singles, and I think these are two very savvy business ladies.
Yeah.
And they know, like Cardi B especially, she was an influencer, she knows how to generate hype, and I would position that a lot of this is actually around the hype more than a genuine feud. Well, who knows? I mean, the bump was pretty real.
Looked like a real bump. I mean, it's all we've talked about for the last few weeks on this show, so it's working.
Did you say that?
Yeah.
But I feel like after today's show, we're going to go and reevaluate all our relationships that we have.
Definitely. What would you say is like,
that person's not real?
The one takeaway then, Evelyn, if we've fallen out with somebody and we want to patch it back up, what would be the one piece of advice you would give?
I would say take a step back from the situation and just quiet your mind, ignore what everyone else is saying, and just feel your way through it. If you feel like you want to patch something up and that would be better for you and your life in that situation, then go for it. If you feel like forgiveness would set you free to be able to move on, then do that. If you just want to sort of quietly write your own letter and then burn it and that's your closure, then maybe do that. But just take a step back and just ignore all the noise, because actually it's just about you. And when you make decisions that are based on you authentically, like, you just can't lose.
Love that.
Woo!
Yes, thank you so much, Evelyn.
That was so amazing. And thank you so much. That was What to Do If.